podcast where we share tips, insight, tools, and stories from other change makers designed to motivate you to become the change you want to see in your world. Make sure you join our Changemakers community at dronemagnus.com/podcast. And now it is time for you to sit back, relax, and enjoy. Good afternoon. We are live once more with one more beautiful Changemakers by my side. This time it is no other than Monique Blocksiel. Tell you a little bit about Monique. She is the founder of the Business Launch Portal, where they help entrepreneurs to build scalable businesses so they stop selling their time, earn a six-figure income, and more, and to have a bigger impact, and I'm sure to have more fun if I know Monique correctly. Monique is also an awarded international speaker. She's a trainer, she's a coach, and a published author. And most importantly, she's a change maker. She's won the public speaking Toastmasters competition twice on the European level and has shared the stage with top entrepreneurs, motivational speakers, and political leaders like Gary Vaynerchuk, Sharon Rouche, former US Foreign Minister John Kerry, Malaysian Prime Minister. Oh my God, I can go on and on with all those names that you have been talking, sharing stage with, Monique. This is amazing. And what I think is one of the things where Monique can really help people and leaders out there is to speak up, scale up, and make a difference. And that is exactly her tagline, her brand tagline. So welcome, Monique, to our Changemakers interview podcast. Thrilled to have you on board with me. Are you okay?
Absolutely. It's wonderful to be here with you, Runa. Whatever you do is always fun and inspirational.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I think if there is anything that I know that you and I will be doing, are doing together, it has to do with change. It has to do with being a little bit bold and fun. So, yeah, so we're definitely going to be having fun today. We're going to be covering a topic that I think most of us can complicate tremendously, and that is selling things. And now in this interview, I specifically want to talk about the power of influencing in the selling process, meaning selling your idea, selling your how to influence people so that they do buy the things that you are sharing with them. I think for many people that is a huge struggle. Am I right, Monique?
Oh yeah, it's one of the difficult, most difficult things to communicate, to influence, communicate, to convince.
Exactly, yeah. So I'm excited because I know you have a lot of experience in this field, and I'm just going to go straight to my first question. How did you become so good at this yourself, pitching an idea and influencing people to buy into those things?
Well, how do you get good at anything in business or life? It's pretty much you're passionate about it in the first place, right? Mm. So I always love to say I'm passionate about three things in life. One is entrepreneurship, one is speaking, and the third is my husband. Of course, not in that order, right? But entrepreneurship is all about building something out of nothing, you know, building, turning a one-man show like a single entrepreneurship into something scalable. So helping people to go away from having a job, even though they're self-employed in their job, and turning that into a scalable business so they're not selling their time anymore. That's what I'm passionate about. And then the speaking side. And where both of them meet, so let's keep my husband out of it, out of business.
Okay.
He has his own thing. Okay. Where entrepreneurship meets speaking, and I'm a speaker all over the globe. I love being on stage. I love bringing other people on the stage. That's why I'm also running a speaker platform to help people grow the speaker business. But where entrepreneurship meets speaking, this is what I call pitching. And often enough, I give workshops and speeches about how you convince anyone of anything almost every time. You know, so I work a lot with entrepreneurs, and I know that equally entrepreneurs that are just starting out as entrepreneurs that have been in their business for 20 years and longer, or even other business leaders in corporates, they struggle so much with bringing their message across and making a complicated topic look simple so that they get the buy-in from people, not only get the buy-in from their mind, but also touch their heart. And I work a lot with entrepreneurs, I work a lot with business leaders, and also I work a lot with entrepreneurs that want to, you know, get investment from investors. They sometimes have 2 minutes or 3 minutes or 5 minutes to explain what they do and convince and really, you know, trigger enough interest for them to get into conversation. That's an art, to convince someone fast. No one has time anymore in today's world. So what do you say and how do you say it to trigger interest fast? And that is what I've been doing for years. And the more often I do it, every time I learn something, and the better I get.
Exactly. And I know you've been making quite a lot of impact with that skill set that you have developed. And I've also seen you on stage where you are doing this in your flow and people are just going, oh, I want to know more. And they find that they have a tool in their hands that they can really use and implement in their business on so many levels, like you're mentioning. What do you see the most common mistakes leaders are making when they want to implement change in their organizations when it comes to their pitch and influencing people?
Right. So there's different mistakes that I see people and leaders make. In organizations, one of these mistakes is they talk so much about themselves instead of talking to the people in front of them. They just, you know, I mean, even if you look at websites, for example, right? I mean, what do websites say? I'm a coach. I'm a speaker. I'm a software developer. I'm a leadership trainer. Yeah. So they speak about themselves instead of speaking to the people in front of them. So instead of saying, I'm a leadership coach or a leadership trainer, why don't you go and you say to people, you know, let's make sure that everyone in your team that comes into your office in the morning has a sparkle of joy in their eyes, right? Or why don't you just say, you know, when we work together, or, you know, would you not want to have a team where people understand each other blind and everyone is really knows their space and they love to go for a bigger vision and purpose together? So I feel that a lot of people just talk about themselves. And also, you spoke about leaders. I mean, we go through constant change in our businesses and our organizations all the time. And I've seen that. I've been working in big corporates myself for 15 years, and I had teams all over the world. And what is happening that leaders, they come to their teams and they announce a change, and they jump right into it. They jump right into it and they say, we're gonna merge with that business, or we're gonna cut, our teams by 50%, or we're gonna, you know, I mean, scary messages like that, right?
Yeah.
And they just jump into it right away without even inviting people to get onto the journey with them. Okay. I mean, if you cut your team by 50% is a tough message in itself, right? It doesn't need to be such a drastic message. It could also be that you say, we will merge with another business, or we will, you know, implement a new product, or we will follow a new strategy. Instead of just announcing it straight, you know, just get people on board. It's like you kind of push them into a running train instead of, you know, just enjoying a glass of champagne with them before you even go on the train and give them like a little bit of an introduction, right? And that's the same also when I see people pitch their business or their business idea. They just, you know, how do they open up? They say, my name is, and I'm going to present you this. This is so boring. Why not starting with a hook? Why not giving people a context, bringing them on board of what you will present by asking a question, by telling a story, or something like that? Also, a big one is that a lot of leaders, they just, again, go into what they tell you the what. What are we going to do, right? What is the plan? What's the strategy we want to, you know, implement in our organization? What's the change we want to make? Why don't you start with, Why do you want to make that change?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so don't sell the what, sell the why. That's what I always say, also as entrepreneurs. Don't sell the, you know, we're going to run this project together like a lot of consultants. What do? They go into an organization and say, so we're going to implement a new product in the market. So first we're going to do this and this analysis, and then we, you know, and then we interview a lot of people, and then we have workshops, and they just describe the journey. They describe the process. But they're not telling me how my life or my work is going to look like at the end of this process. So don't get the people to, don't bore the people by telling them all the steps you plan to take, but rather make them see how their world is going to look like at the end of it. Because then they might be open to change. Then they might be open to even add a lot of additional effort or, you know, go through uncomfortable change times. If they understand what is the end result you want to create and why is their life and work going to be better at the end of it.
So that's a really good example that you're giving for someone that comes in and starts with all the processes and all the steps. Now, let's say that someone is coming in and that's the thing. They're selling an idea for a product or services to use that is going to change the environment in the business. So instead of going from the steps and you say share the story or share the end result, so are there any steps that you can take or any like questions that you can ask yourself so that when you're preparing that you can turn that steps into the process of going back straight into that feeling, that champagne that you mentioned earlier?
Yes. So let me give you two suggestions, okay?
Yeah.
One is that, as you said, you mentioned it yourself as well. A lot of people just give a lot of data, facts, and figures, okay?
Yeah.
They say, our situation is that, and then they have one chart, and then they say, okay, and this is what we're going to change and how we change, and then there's another chart. Why don't you just tell stories, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Rather tell people stories and say, okay, so when we're going to, you know, for example, let's say we want to implement a change in our organization. Mm-hmm. Why don't you tell a story of how another organization implemented that and what it did and what good it brought to their team members and their leaders and their clients? You see what
mm-hmm.
I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
just wrap things into stories instead of just really presenting all the data, fact, and figures and mm-hmm. make it sound like it's all decided, but rather get people onto a journey. Instead mm-hmm. of pushing them into a train, make them see where they're going to get off the train. Okay?
Yeah.
Make it fun for them. Make sure that even before they go on the train, that they are surrounded by people they enjoy the ride with. Make sure that they have a lunch pack, including some champagne or something else, that they will, you know, enjoy while they're on the ride.
Yeah.
You see? So wrap it into stories. That's one thing. Another thing is often, I don't know if you know that, but when you go into businesses, and I plead guilty because when I worked in the corporate world, I was speaking that language too. A lot of people speak such a difficult language, okay? Mm-hmm. So in the corporate language, that would sound like, you know what, and he had been on TV, on a TV duel with Romney. And I was there at that time, and in the morning I was in the fitness center on a stepper, and on the TV screen, they would show this TV duel. And mm-hmm. then every time they would say something, you would see if the number of voters would go up or would go down. And me being a speaker, that was like paradise for me because it really made me see the power of language. Because what I realized is that it didn't matter if Obama or Romney were saying something, you know, what mattered was word is using a language that would touch people's hearts. So no matter who spoke about, let's make sure our children have healthy food when they come to school, the votes would go up. Everyone sees kids eating healthy food. That language creates pictures. But when they spoke about unemployment rates, statistics, and so on, the votes would go down.
Yeah.
And I found this amazing, and it just showed me again and size how important it is that you're not using this language that I said earlier with the return investment and maximizing mm-hmm. synergy and blah, blah, blah. This is what I call bullshit bingo language. So when you have a message to share, yes, share data, facts, and figures, but also share stories in simple languages. So these are just two suggestions that I also share with people I work with.
Yeah. And I totally get that. I don't think that when you're saying this, I'm thinking about, you know, when we go and we buy a trip somewhere abroad for a vacation, I don't think we would be buying that trip if it would be, well, first you need to be at the airport 2 hours before, and you have to go through security, and, you know, you have all these people that are there, and they're grumpy as hell, and then you go through, after that, you have to wait probably at the plane for the runway, and normally the planes are late, you know. If you would really go into all that details of how to get abroad for your vacation, you probably would never go. But instead, they keep showing us that palm trees. Exactly. And pictures of happy people on the beach. Yeah.
Exactly. You got it perfectly. That's exactly what you should do. And still so many people don't do it.
Yeah. It's one of those things that are so simple. It's right in front of us, but we don't.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's right in front of us. Yeah, exactly. But we somehow don't do it. So tell me, what questions do you most often get from leaders who want to drive change in their organization and want to sell their ideas to the team? What do they most often ask you?
Well, I mean, there's a gazillion questions all the time, of course. But, you know, one of the questions from entrepreneurs, for example, or even business leaders is they say, oh, yeah, Monique, your 7-step approach really makes perfect sense. However, our situation, our project, our business is so complicated. Okay. People say, okay, but ours is more difficult. It's more complex. It's really, really hard for us to put that into simple steps, into simple languages, find a story that grabs people's minds and hearts. So that's what a lot of people struggle with. Or they say, yeah, I know in general what I will present, but I don't know how to open my presentation. I don't know what to say at the beginning to grab people's attention fast. Or they say, well, yeah, but, you know, how can I really trigger interest for what I want to implement? And then I always give an advice, for example, always first sell the problem and then the solution. So, you know, switch your perspective and step into the shoes of the people that you want to present it to and ask yourself, what are they not happy with at the moment? Or what are their aspirations? What would they like to have more of? And then weave that into your speech, into your pitch, and make them see and feel that this is what they want even before you start presenting your solution.
Yeah.
And this is, you know, some of the suggestions that I give. And these are some of the questions that I get.
Yeah.
How do I convince people? How do I make them see that what you want to implement as change, or the product you want to sell, or the project you want to start, that this is something valuable to me? So these are some of the questions I always get.
Yeah, exactly. And I can envision that that's a very common question, no matter basically where in the world you are. It has nothing to do with cultures, or it's just the same thing that pops up. I know that with your work and what you've been doing so far, it's really been helping entrepreneurs and leaders who are leading their team or leading the organization, business or community or even nations, that's so to speak, to really drive through that change and be able to speak up in a way that it has an impact and it makes a difference in the world. When you are teaching and when you are working with people as their consultant or as their coach, how quickly do you see people are getting the results from the technique that you're teaching?
Well, that's the beauty of it, Runa. Honestly, it's pretty right away, okay? It's sometimes within minutes, sometimes within hours, definitely within days.
Oh, wow.
And, yeah, because, you know, the great thing also is that, you know, knowing what to say and how to say things to convince people. You use it in your business. You use it in your career. You use it in your private life. You can convince clients, investors, team members, or your mother-in-law, okay? And, you know, pretty much all the time, yeah, you know, we always communicate with a purpose, with an intention.
Yeah.
all the time in business and in private life. And, you know, often, really, pretty much almost every time I give a workshop or a speech, someone comes back to me, sometimes the same evening, sometimes the next day, sometimes a few days later, and they say, you know what, Monique, I started to communicate in a different way already on the way home, and I made an appointment right away, the same day. Yeah. Or, you know, when I spoke in Boston last year, one came back saying to me, you know what, the next day I had a client appointment, and I started to speak to them differently, and guess what, we closed the deal right away. So again, you know, this is, you know, when you take these hints away and you apply them right away, you will see results right away. That is the magic of the work I do. And it's not for me, you know, I really help people to embrace this. Mm-hmm. And as you said, it's all around us. All I do is I make people see how they can do it for themselves, for their business, for their team, for their product, and so on. So, you know, it's applicable right away. And, you know, whenever we learn something, we should try things right away.
Yeah. Just try it right away. Exactly.
Yes.
I think this is the perfect ending of a really, really insightful and not only insightful, but informative ways to have an influence, to speak up, to scale up and make a difference in your organization, in your team, in your community, in your business, wherever you are leading. And I want to advise you to that. Monique is one of the change makers, so you can find everything about her on ronamagnus.com. You will also find a whole lot about her and her programs on businesslaunchportal.com. And there will be more things below when we have this whole thing online. And yes, you wanted to say something? Yes.
Yeah, thank you. You know, we only had 20 minutes, which is pretty much nothing to really go into this topic. So what if you go to businesslaunchportal.com, you will find right away the pitch checklist there. So it really maps out what are the steps to pitch, and it gives you space to really, you know, implement it for yourself, your business, your team right away. So if you go to businesslaunchportal.com, you find the pitch checklist is free. Download it, use it, and let Runa and let me know, you know, how it's serving you and what right away what impact you're generating with your communication to convince pretty much anyone of anything almost every time.
Love it. Thank you so much, Monique, for all your help and all your insights. It's a bless from me over here. Until next time. Yeah. If so, feel free to share the love and give us your generous review on iTunes, Stitcher, or Spotify. And remember, you can always go to runamagnus.com and find out more about the changemakers and how we can help you driving the change you want to see in your life.